In 2010, Brett Bielema was one of the top coaches in the nation, and he almost won the Coach of the Year award. But then he did something that shocked a lot of people. He left Wisconsin for Arkansas. Many people questioned his thought process and wondered why he did it and if it would work. Probably because it was the SEC, and he wanted more money for his coordinators, and many thought he could help Arkansas compete in the West. But in retrospect, things never really worked out in Fayetteville for Brett, and now he is out of the college football coaching landscape. Today I'm joined by Jonathan from Embrace the Grind, and as a Wisconsin super fan, he's going to talk about the rise of Brett and his time at Wisconsin, and I will cover his downfall at Arkansas and where he is now. But first, be sure to subscribe to his channel, and if you love college football, subscribe to my channel, as I'm trying to hit 25,000 subscribers by the end of December, and I really need your guys' help. Be sure to give the video a like, share it with your friends, comment your thoughts, suggest who I should do next, and stay until the end. And now let's get started and talk about the downfall of Brett Bielema.
Hey guys, my name is Jonathan from Embrace the Grind. I want to thank Scott for letting me join him on this video. Brett Bielema played as a defensive lineman at Iowa and was coached by Hayden Fry from 1989 to 1992. When he was a senior, he was actually named a team captain. Things were not all great during Bielema's senior year though, as he would make an inappropriate comment to the Iowa State head coach after they beat them for the fifth time while Bielema was at Iowa. Bielema would go on to play for the Milwaukee Mustangs, a team from the Arena Football League. After his time with the Mustangs, he returned to Iowa to serve as a graduate assistant and later linebacker coach for the Hawkeyes until 2001. Then he would spend 2 years at Kansas State as a co-defensive coordinator before leaving K-State for the defensive coordinator job at Wisconsin. Bielema's hire was set up as a head coach in waiting since Barry Alvarez was in his 15th year coaching at Wisconsin. In 2004, Bielema's first season with the Badgers, they would go 9-3 and lose to Georgia in the Outback Bowl. Bielema's defense ranked 6th in the nation for points allowed with 15.4 a game. In 2005, Barry Alvarez announced it was going to be his last year coaching and that Bielema was going to replace him following the season. The Badgers went 10-3 and finished 3rd in the Big Ten. They beat Auburn 24-10 in the Capital One Bowl. Bielema's defense finished 48th in points allowed per game. Bielema's first season as Wisconsin's head coach was the most successful season in program history at that point. After starting the season unranked, Wisconsin lost only one game, at Michigan, and tied with Michigan for second in the Big Ten. The Badgers ended the season with a 17-14 win in the Capital One Bowl against the Arkansas Razorbacks, and ranked 7th by the AP. After beginning the 2007 season ranked 7th by the AP, Wisconsin's rank dropped quickly following a 31-26 loss at Illinois and a 38-7 blowout loss at Penn State in the middle of the season. The team ended the season in 4th place in the Big Ten and ranked 24th by the AP. They then lost the Outback Bowl 21-17 against Tennessee. Wisconsin began the 2008 season ranked 13th but ended unranked with a 3-5 record in Big Ten play. The team then got blown out 42-13 by Florida State in the Champ Sports Bowl. The Badgers turned their fortunes around in Bielema's fourth season, winning 10 of their 13 games, including a 37-0 shutout of Purdue and a 20-14 win over number 14 Miami in the Citrus Bowl. They ended the season ranked 16th in the AP poll. The Badgers continued to improve in the fifth season under Bielema, finishing with an 11-2 record as Big Ten co-champions with Michigan State, the team that gave them their only loss during the regular season. The season included a 31-18 win over number 1 Ohio State in Madison. I remember that game like it was yesterday, folks. The team's record earned them a trip to the Rose Bowl, Bielema's first as a coach and the school's 7th. They lost the Rose Bowl 21-19 to TCU, but ended ranked number 7th by the AP. Wisconsin's success continued in the 2011 season as the Badgers went 11-3 to finish first in the new Leaders Division of the Big Ten. They then defeated Michigan State 42-39 in the first ever Big Ten championship game and won a second Rose Bowl berth in a row. They lost the Rose Bowl 45-38 to Oregon and finished the season ranked number 10 by the AP. This was the year of Russell Wilson, by the way. The Badgers slid somewhat back down to earth in Bielema's seventh season as head coach, ending the season with an 8-6 record, winning the Big Ten championship 70-31 against Nebraska and earning a third trip to the Rose Bowl. I had so much fun watching this game, guys. It was insane. However, 3 days after UW's Big Ten blowout, Bielema announced that he was leaving the school to take the head coaching job at Arkansas. This shocked Badger fans because it was so unexpected. Former head coach Barry Alvarez stepped in to coach the team in the Rose Bowl, which UW lost 20-14 against Stanford. 3 Rose Bowl trips, 3 straight losses. Bielema ended his Wisconsin head coaching career with a 68-24 overall record and 37-19 Big Ten record. While at Wisconsin, he would never really get recruiting going, as from 2007 to 2010, his classes dropped from 32nd in the nation down to 46th in the nation, before rebounding to 44th in 2011 but dropping to 65th in 2012. His recruiting classes finished 44th in the nation on average. Two star Wisconsin Badgers from the Bielema era are J.J. Watt and Russell Wilson, like I already mentioned. Bielema went 1-5 against Ohio State and 2-3 against Penn State. Bielema may have viewed Arkansas having a better chance to win a national title than Wisconsin, since at the time, it was the rise of Urban Meyer's Ohio State teams, which went undefeated in Urban Meyer's first season. The Arkansas job offered more money and a chance to play in the SEC. Wisconsin moved on quickly from Bielema by hiring Gary Anderson. Barry Alvarez said on January 17th, "You made the decision to go to Arkansas. Go to Arkansas. Good luck. You don't have to take any swipes. I just didn't appreciate that." As Bielema got into Twitter fights with Badger fans after leaving. Classy. A year later, after Wisconsin lost to Arizona State, Bielema's wife tweeted, "Karma." I'm going to throw it back to Scott to explain why this tweet did not age well for Brett Bielema.
After leaving Wisconsin, Bielema arrived to Arkansas, replacing Bobby Petrino and John Smith. Jim Chaney and Chris Ash were his assistants, and he inherited a roster without a whole lot of talent and developed guys. He'd be in for a really tough job, and it would show in his first season. He had Brandon Allen as his quarterback, Alex Collins and Jonathan Williams as his running backs, and a young Hunter Henry as his best weapon in the passing game. They won their first three games against non-Power 5 schools, and then reality would hit for the program. They lost to Rutgers, and then lost to five straight ranked teams, and they are at 3-6. They then also lost their last three games, two of which were close, but the Razorbacks went 3-9 in Brett's first year. Chris Ash left for Ohio State after the year, and Rob Smith was hired as the defensive coordinator. Arkansas returned a lot of weapons and were expected to take a jump in 2014. This was the best SEC West division ever, though, and it honestly deserves its own video, as at one point, six of the seven teams were ranked in the top 15. They lost to Auburn in their first game, and this was a 10-game losing streak, the longest in program history, but then they won three straight, and he got his first big win against Texas Tech. They then lost three straight games to ranked opponents, including an overtime loss to Texas A&M and a one-point loss to Alabama. They beat UAB before a close loss to number 1 Mississippi State. They then shut out number 17 LSU and number 8 Ole Miss by a combined score of 47-0. This was the first time in college football history that a team had shut out back-to-back ranked opponents, and they'd have a chance to do it a third time against number 17 Missouri the following week. They were actually winning in the fourth quarter, but Matty Mock led Mizzou back, and they ended up winning the game and went to the SEC championship game. Arkansas was super impressive, though, how they finished, and they ended up having a 7-6 record after beating Texas in the Texas Bowl. Going into 2015, Jim Chaney was gone, and Dan Enos came in as the offensive coordinator. They had a ton of hype as they were ranked number 18 to start the season, and this is exactly what Bielema was brought in to do. After beating UTEP, they dropped a game to Toledo at home, and this was a bad loss. Yes, Toledo is a terrible loss, but at the same time, Matt Campbell was the coach there, so it's not as bad as you think. They would lose two more games to Texas Tech and Texas A&M, and all of a sudden, the rails were falling off. They beat Tennessee in a close game before they lose to Alabama on the road. They didn't know what to do as they were 2-4, but then they won four straight games, including ranked wins over Ole Miss and LSU, before a loss to Mississippi State. In that stretch, they beat Auburn in four overtime. And had a miracle play on 4th-and-26, where Hunter Henry threw the ball behind his head and it bounced into Alex Collins' hands. He took it 26 yards for the first down. Then a few plays later, Brandon Allen took a QB sneak in and won the game. They killed Missouri before they beat Kansas State in the Liberty Bowl and finished with an 8-5 record. Not exactly where Razorbacks fans wanted it, but he had saved the season and there was a lot of hype. Going into the next season, Brandon Allen was gone, but the Allens were going to stay in the program as his little brother Austin Allen had taken over the quarterback duties. Raleigh Williams was going to be the running back to replace Alex Collins as well. Keon Hatcher would become the go-to guy on offense, and Brooks Ellis was the leader of the defense. They beat number 15 TCU in week 2 in double overtime and were ranked number 24 in the country, but they lost 4 of their next 7 games to ranked opponents and were kind of the definition of mediocre. They had beaten number 12 Ole Miss and number 10 Florida. They lost to Virginia Tech in the Belk Bowl, and his seat was kind of warm. 2017 was going to be the make or break year for Brett, and he would have to do well without a go-to wide receiver, and Raleigh Williams retired because of a neck injury. They lost 5 of their first 7 games, and all of them were to SEC opponents. They beat Ole Miss for the 4th time, but at this point, the fan base was calling for his head. They beat Coastal Carolina, a win that didn't look as good then as it does now, to get to 4-5, but they lost LSU, Mississippi State, and Missouri to finish the season, and the Razorbacks went 4-8 with a 1-7 conference record and a last place finish in the West. Apparently, Bielema was fired heading to the locker room after the Missouri game, and the administration didn't even let him go back to his own locker room. They then hired an even worse coach in Chad Morris, and Arkansas is slowly trying to rebuild under Sam Pittman and Barry Odom. After this, Bielema joined the New England Patriots staff and became a defensive line coach in 2019 under Bill Belichick, and in 2020 he moved over to the Giants and is a linebackers coach there. He's still relatively young at under 50 years old, so he's either going to spend time as an assistant in the NFL, or maybe he can get back into the college football landscape. But let's talk about why Brett Bielema failed to work at Arkansas. A lot of people say his recruiting philosophy was doomed from the start. The state of Arkansas doesn't produce a ton of offensive linemen, and that was something that he had specialized in at Wisconsin. He developed 9 All-Americans in 8 years, but there wasn't that kind of high school talent in the area, and if there were, all the other big SEC schools were grabbing him up. Plus, after his first few classes, there wasn't a lot of talent being developed. But since he was an established coach before, Bielema was supposed to lead Arkansas to SEC championships. Instead, the Hogs only finished better than 5th place one time in his 5 years. He lost so many games to ranked teams and could never get over that hump. That year they were supposed to be really good, they blew it to Toledo, and that kind of messed up the season and kind of tarnished his reputation. I alluded to it earlier, but his offensive line was never quite there, and the pass protection wasn't really that good by the end of it. His defenses lack speed, according to a lot of articles I've read, and they could just never put it all together. But the main reason he didn't end up succeeding is the fact that he was a Midwest Big Ten coach, trying to coach in the best division in college football, where he didn't have access to what made him successful at Wisconsin. Plus, when he left, the expectations went through the roof, and he was kind of doomed to fail. But what do you guys think? If you're an Arkansas fan, let me know what you think of Bielema. If you're just a normal fan, let me know what you think of Bielema, and let me know what coach I should cover next. Before you go, be sure to give the video a like, subscribe to my channel, and subscribe to Jonathan's channel, and check out my video about what happened to Alex Collins if you're an Arkansas fan. Hope to see you guys again soon, but until next time, peace.